that novel coronavirus outbreak is not just distancing us socially, but from our humaneness as well. The news about public denying COVID-19 victims a dignified farewell coming out of various parts of the country corroborate this to be a fact. From the case of the Bengaluru doctor to the 83-year-old Kottayam man, the forces driving the mass are the same: fear and ignorance. In all these cases, the cremations or burial took place only after law enforcing agencies exercised coercive forces. Sensitizing the public is the only way to end this conflict. So we have Dr. Jameela on call with us to explain the protocols and guidelines on disposal of the bodies of those who died of suspected or confirmed COVID-19 infection.
First of all, we must understand that before getting an infection of coronavirus from a dead body is very, very low when compared to a patient. The virus spreads usually through coughing and sneezing or talking from a patient. That too, the virus will spread only up to 1 or 1.5 meters from the patient. In a dead body, that will not happen. The dead body cannot cough or sneeze. And it's true that the virus will remain in the body fluids for some few hours. Mm-hmm. Or how many hours, we are not sure, because there is no study that about the virus being inside the body for how long time, you don't know.
Unlike in the case of Ebola, cholera, etc., the dead bodies of COVID-19 infected patients are generally not infectious. The main driver of transmission of COVID-19 is through bodily fluids. According to the health authorities, the risk of spreading COVID infection from a dead body to a healthcare worker or a family member who follows standard precautions while handling an infectious body is highly unlikely. The most vulnerable people to the infection would be those handling the autopsy, as they might have to handle the lungs of the victim. According to the World Health Organization, there's no evidence of persons having becoming infected from exposure to the bodies of persons who have died from COVID-19 to date. However, standard precautions are to be followed by healthcare workers while handling bodies of those who died due to COVID-19.
Once the patient is declared dead, the doctors as well as the staff in the hospital will remove all the tubes from the body and all the orifices will be packed so that not much secretion will come out from the body. Then the body is cleaned with bleach solution that is antiseptic, and it will kill all the coronavirus which is spread over the surfaces of the body. Then it is packed with clothes twice, and again it is packed in a plastic bag.
Okay.
And that is why we are not handing over the body to the relatives for any rituals, because of the chance of getting the infection through the body fluids, and we are avoiding all rituals like kissing or hugging the body and all. So that is why the body is directly taken to the cremation ground. So any type of cremation will be applicable to a dead body with the corona infected patient, because any type that is cremation through fire or electric cremation or deep burial. The only when you bury, it should be a deep pit that is 6 feet. It should be taken, and then you can bury the body. And as soon as possible, the body should be buried, because when you keep the body for long time, secretions may come out from the body and you can get infection.
Touching of the dead body is strictly not allowed. The burial staff along with the family members should perform hand hygiene after cremation. The ash does not pose any risk and can be collected to complete the last rites of the infected person. However, large gathering at the burial ground should be avoided to maintain social distancing.
As a responsible citizen, you should understand that the chance of getting infection from the body is very minimal. And the chance of getting it only those who are handling the body. Those who are handling the body are healthcare workers. They know how to handle the body. They are experienced in it. And they have been given So they will handle it properly, and nobody need to worry about that.